Welcome to the next edition of Hit and Run Fishing. It's dark, it's low tide, I'm on the rocks. I thought I'd give it a bash because the tides were really small, we're on little neaps, we're just coming off the bottom of the smallest neap. That was yesterday, so today's slightly bigger, but I've got a nice slack tide period for about 3 hours tonight from 8 p.m. onwards. So I thought I'd come down and try one of the iconic Dorset rock mount. I'm hoping for maybe a conger, maybe a huss, maybe a bass. Bait wise, I've got anchovies, squid, and I did a bit of foraging earlier on, if anything. And I got me a load of these. These are, I think they're called spiny cockles, but they're massive. You can see the size of it as we fish. I've got 9 of them, I've got 10 anchovies, and a couple of squid. Fishing pulley rigs, one with a 6-0 with the anchovies on, one with a 4-0 with a clam on. So we'll see what we can do. You never know, might even find a codling on the clam. So we should give it a try, see how we go. So the baits tonight are pretty simple on the one rod. We've got a single 6-0 tamer, with a whole anchovy and a strip of squid. It's a 150-pound pulley rig, it's about 4 feet long. With a couple of swivel, with a couple of big beads, big swivel, and a rotten bottom link. It's all tangled up. There we go. Absolutely bog standard. And then the other bait I've got are these. You see the size of it. And that's what it looks like when it comes out the shell. I haven't never used these before. I thought I'd just treat them a bit like carp. Snip on the old double needle. Whip it on up. Instead of going with a 6-0, this one's going on a single 4-0. It whips into a big shellfishy lump. Put a few rattles on the first bait that's already out there. Something like that, start. Then we get the rig out. Elon, yeah, first chuck wonder. Ourselves an eel. Nice. Let's get him rebaited, get him back out there, and then we'll deal with him. Alright, onwards. Back in a moment. Right, I'll have to be quick doing this because the fish bait's off again. Okay, so I've got me clam, I wound it up on her. I'll get through the top once. Again through the bottom to leave the eider hook. I'll leave quite a long tag end, about 10mm out of my heavy rigs. It's a 4-0 must have big gun with a 100-pound snood on it, just in case I get an eel on it. That's as simple as that. Wind them up. Like that. Plenty around your hook eye, around the hook point, down around the shank. Simple as that. That's on. 4 foot long, 100-pound pulley rig, down the usual, couple of beads, swivel, 6 ounce nearmix. Right, onwards. Well, story of the night so far is don't cast too far because I think there's a line of pots out there. My third set of lost gear. I'm winding about 15-20 turns, comes off the bottom clean, and then it just goes a real long pull of a snag and you cannot shift it. You get a bit and you take a bit, you get a bit, you take a bit. I end up losing a lot, so I should drop them in slightly shorter. I'll re-rig with a fresh 70-pound leader. That's what's in the box. It's only really rubbing leader on the rocks anyway. Yeah, Albright knot. It's £25. Just make that a bit shorter, make it easier for myself. Yeah, back out another. And shall we on this one? And the clam on t'other one at the moment. There's not a lot going on. Few knocks, few taps. Not that much. Fishing with the usual gear, WR300s from Century, with Saltish black and gold 30s. So £25, I think this is Pazzo I got right here today. Asso, £25 mainline, £70 Ultima. Leader. Always down to a breakaway clip. Fast link style clip. So I do love double pattern. If I do get it in, it's a lot easier, especially with the rotten bottoms. Lovely, right. That gets one back out, but not quite as far. Right, I'm getting a few good knocks on the left hand rod at the moment. Fighting away for a minute or two now. Supercharged with a bit of coffee. Still there. Sometimes the eels will pick up the bait, give it a little mouth, put it down again, pick it up, give it a mouth, put it down. That could be a rock there. Biggest traits of the eels, they'll give you a very slight drop back moment when they come towards you, so you feel the tension going away. So they come in, and that's when they get under a rock and you don't know and you lose everything. Hello. down the rock. Left it a second, as long as the people come up on the top, see if I can get them out. Say no more. Strap about £3. Nothing dramatic eel wise, but he gave me about a 4 or 5 foot zzz on the ratchet, just get me heart going. All right, I'll get him unhooked, get him back. Right, I'm getting a good eel here. Good eel. Feel it pulling and banging. I think this thing's back. Take your mind. I should just piss it off. Give it some slack. The other one's got a conger snag on it too. You can feel it on there still, like do-do-do-do. You can feel it spinning. He spun around that pot rope, he's fun. It's still there. Way down tight now. Come on, come out of it. See that? Right around me under the rock. Come on. Taking the clam as well. Come on. Feed him on there. crazy, Tom. Bring the slack line again. On the ratchet. Down the back to the lever. That's a big eel on there, and I think he's running that pot line. Still there.
I don't even see the rod tips. See what I mean? He's definitely still on there.
Take all the slack I can. And I give everything back this way I can. Moving.
This, my friends, is reality. Just another level. Visit the Maldives with Virgin Atlantic Holidays. Book now.
This is absolutely.
What's moving? Further through the snow. Oh, it's gone. It's gone. It's gone. Bollocks. Oh, bollocks. What'd you do? That was a big, big eel. I'll come back in a minute. Right, now I managed to compose myself after losing that colossal beast. I then lost everything on the other rod as well. Because I was trying to bring that one in, when that rod went off with the ratchet, on the ratchet. Couldn't stop it, couldn't turn it, couldn't get it back through a snag. What'd you do? In words of Quint, you lose one, you rig one. Back out, back at it, let's have another go. Then again, I could think to myself, how am I going to land that big bastard on my own? Got the drop net, but we'd have to have a real good bit of luck with this. But we hooked it. That's the second one from this mark I've hooked this flat rod in me. Right, back in the motor. I sort of gave up in the last cast. I was slightly dejected after losing that beast, but I will be back. I will. So please, like and subscribe. I've had loads of recent subscribers, loads of views on my videos. Please keep it up. Send me the likes, stick a comment on it. It's been great. But please keep watching. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. It's free. throw me a like, throw me a comment, see me lose some more fish. I hope not. I really hope not. Right, cheers guys. Night night.